हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ रेखा चौहान, GRWPC जोधपुर। टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ इंटीरियर डिजाइनिंग। इंटीरियर डिजाइन इज द आर्ट एंड प्रोसेस ऑफ डिजाइनिंग एंड फॉर्मुलेटिंग ए गिवन स्पेस टू क्रिएट ए फंक्शनल इंटीरियर। देर आर सेवरल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ इंटीरियर डिजाइन विच वर्क्स एज बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स फॉर द डिजाइन प्रोसेस। Knowledge of all these elements, functions and characteristics can be utilized and put together to create a dynamic interior. Each of these elements has its own nature and specifications. The standards of them help in applying them into a space to make it into more sophisticated area. The basic elements of interior design are space, line, shape and form, texture and color. Element of design, space. Space is the area in which we work. It defines limits and sets boundaries of our design. It is limited by width, length and height. To make a space seem larger, use soft, light, cool colors. And to make space seem smaller, use patterns or dark, warm colors. Space is the actual place which will be converted into a functional and stylish interior by designing and adding up elements of design. Walls, ceilings, floors, room, etc. are the space or the blank canvas to work with. For any interior designing to start, one must observe the space first, get all the visual perceptions to start the further planning. Space planning is the core concept for designing any interior. Through this, we get the idea of the size, shape, and kinds requirement for the given space and design the further elements accordingly, such as which type of furniture, lighting, which color, pattern, and texture needed to given certain effects, and so on. Space can be split into two categories, positive and negative space. Positive space is space containing objects, whilst negative space is the open or empty space, including any space between objects. Striking a balance between the negative and positive spaces of a room is essential to avoid overcrowding. This balance will be influenced by the client's need in the specific area or room and its required functionality. Element of design, line. What is a line? Line is the extension of a single point. It is a mark or stroke that is longer than its width. Objects and things are perceived by line that describes them. Line establishes shape and form. It suggests movement and leads or moves the eye around the room. Lines are either straight or curved. Straight lines are considered to be more masculine. Characteristics of line include thick, thin, long, short, continuous, broken. Direction of different types of line like vertical, horizontal, curved, diagonal, perpendicular, zigzag, etc. There are different psychological effects produced by different types of lines. The concept of types of line and their effect to our eyes and brain can be used in a total interior design by applying it to other basic elements. The influence of this simple line can make a huge difference in visual perception and impression. Each type of lines have their own visual effect and can be very functional. Vertical lines. These lines suggest immobility, stability, and harmonious relationship to earth. Vertical lines lead the eye up, which can give the impression of height to a short room or add more length to a taller one. This can also create focal points when used in group in a specific area. Thus, a room that is too low can be made to appear high by painting ceiling lighter than walls and using vertical accessories like vertical wall hangings, photo strips on wallpaper, etc. Same way, short windows may have long, narrow draperies. Diagonal lines. Depending on the angle, diagonal lines can vary on steepness. They symbolize movement, direction, action, angular stability. The angular line stimulates the eye and mind and make them more interesting than regular parallel lines. These can be overpowering, so should be used sparingly. Dynamic or angular lines, which are action-oriented, add drama and can be seen on structures like stairs. Horizontal lines. These lines lead the lines left to right, suggesting their stability, restfulness, and formality. Same like horizon, horizontal line give the illusion for enlarged space if used right angle to the vertical lines. These reinforces sleep and rest perceptions, thus depicts peace and relaxation. Can be seen in sofas, chests, rugs, and tables. To increase width of room, rugs may be so placed that the eye travel across the room. Interior designers highlight horizontal lines to make a room appear wider and longer and shorter, and to draw the eye to a focal point. But be careful, overemphasis of horizontal lines has the ability to make the space seem boring and uninspired. Curved lines. These lines are very soft in nature. These lines add interest and relief. These lines are softer and considered to be more feminine. They are assumed soft, humanizing, and more acceptable to our eyes and mind. They provide the message of relief and softness from harsh, sharp lines, represent freedom and natural flow. Series of curved lines is also called arcade, which gives a rhythmic feeling to an interior. Can be seen in doorway arches, ruffled curtains, rounded accessories, staircase, etc. Element of design, shape and form. Every object and element of design are made of shapes. Shapes are the base for any elements and builds up a whole design like circle, square, rectangle, etc. Forms are three-dimensional like sphere, cylinder, cube, etc. Shapes and form can be geometric or organic. Geometric are those because they can be drawn using tools like compass, ruler, and so on. They give an orderly rigidity and systematic feeling. While the organic shapes and forms, they are complex, freehand drawn shapes are normally found in nature like floral prints, leaves, animal prints, etc. Different shapes and forms produce different effects on our brain. All the visual objects can be analyzed in terms of shape. For example, an average house may be perceived as a rectangle with a triangle on the top, and the sun is often presented like a circle with lines around it. People may not always notice what figures and shapes surround them, still they have a great impact on our consciousness and behavior. The science studying the influence of shape on people is known as psychology of shapes. Squares and rectangles. These two shapes are thought to be the most commonly used. We see them many and many times per a day. The walls and furniture, books or monitors, cell phones and cameras, as well as many other everyday things have square or rectangular shape. Straight lines and right angles of these two shapes give a sense of reliability and security. People strongly associate squares and rectangles with buildings, the reason why they bring the feeling of trust and authority. Common meanings that these shapes convey are discipline, strength, courage, security and reliability. Rectangular shapes are more pleasing to the eye than square shapes. Rectangles are most often the dominant shape in a room. Square suggests a rational, stable form with no direction. Circles, ovals, and ellipses. The first and foremost meaning of the shape is the eternity, since they have no beginning or end. The circle has a long association with the sun and earth as well as other cosmic objects, while ellipse is similar to the whole universe. That's why round shapes may give the feeling of magic and mystery. In addition, unlike the previous shapes, circles don't have angles, so it makes them softer and milder. Common meanings that this oval, circular, and ellipse shape convey are eternity, female, universe, magic, and mystery. A triangular shape is a stable, energetic, and dynamic shape which is always associated with motion and direction. The lines are placed that way so our eyes automatically move to the top of the triangle or in the direction it is placed. Triangle can have different meanings. An upright triangle brings the feeling of stability and balance, but the reversed one looks risky and ready to fall, giving people a sense of tense. The meaning they convey are excitement, risk, danger, balance, and stability. Element of design, texture. Texture is the element of art that refers to how things feel on the surface, rough or smooth. Texture is the surface quality of an object, that is, how someone feels when touched or looks like it would feel if touched. For example, sandpaper is rough and velvet is smooth. They are also classified as tactile or visual. Tactile texture are the actual feeling of any surface which we will feel when we touch it, whereas visual texture is our perception how a texture might feel. It is a very powerful tool to add elegance and a subtle style to any interior. It has a lot of functions in interior design as well as used widely for decorative purposes. Our perception of any texture is influenced by from how far or near we are observing, the kind of light falling on it, and the color and type of coatings. Texture can be applied to walls, wall coverings, floors, carpets, rugs, furniture, and other fabric materials. The surface of an object, its smoothness or roughness is another important decorating tool. The use of several complementary textures can add variety and keep interest alive. Be careful to avoid dramatic contrast between the textures. It is not a good idea to use casual rough burlap in the same setting with a sofa, soft and formal moire. Heavily textured, nubby, rough surfaces absorb more light. They are more casual in feeling, they seem to be darker, and they are good at absorbing sound. Smooth and shiny surfaces are more formal. They appear to be lighter and are more reflective of light. Element of design, color. Color is derived from reflected light. Light rays reflected from objects reveal the color of the object. Color is one of the most powerful tools used in interior design. Color should be studied both psychologically and emotionally to be understood and used correctly. The amount of light also affects the color. Dim lighting reduces a color's value and diminishes its hue. Color creates visual impression, focal points, and adds a theme or personality in the space. Lighter color make object look expanded without boundaries, whereas darker one makes it look smaller and enclosed. Proper color scheme must be made for the whole interior so that colors are not disoriented across the space. It should also match with the goal functionality and mood of the room. Interior designers will often incorporate lighter or brighter colors in smaller space to give the illusion of more space. Darker colors can give a powerful dimension to a larger space. Colors are divided into two categories, warm and cool tones. Warm tones like red, orange, and yellow can energize a space and its occupants. Cool tones such as blue, green, and purple generally create quite relaxing atmospheres. Correct usage of color can change the whole impression on space. It can change the perception of room as well as make it from dull to lively place. Using the whole interior using different shades of warm or cool tones will affect the total perception. Black and white in interior design will give it formal and sophisticated look. High lighting levels can either intensify the hue or make the color appear washed out. Color swatches should be tested in the actual location under the expected lighting condition before final decisions are made. The amount of area covered affects the color. Color intensifies as the area of color increases. It is also important to remember that interior colors should be chosen inside and exterior colors outside. Now that you know the elements of interior design, you can better understand them and can make them work for you. Thank you. Have a nice day.